Many of our students responded to this question by saying that the word outlet reminded them of the outlet in the wall. Now, this, as you know, is a connection between electrical appliances at home and the electric grid. In much the same way, an outlet in iOS is also a connection. It's a connection between our code and something on the storyboard. Let's see how this works in code. So to manage screen space, I will slide out the utility area and then go on to the assistant editor, there. Then I will hold down control on my keyboard, click on this label, and then drag to the top of this class and let go. Here I have a pop-up that I can fill in. The type of this connection is an outlet. I will call it recording in progress. The type of this label in iOS is called UI label. UI stands for user interface. And then I will hit connect. Okay, so I have some code here that Xcode has written for me. Let's unpack this line. So we created a variable called recording in progress. The type of this variable is UI label. Here, we also see something called IB outlet. IB stands for interface builder, and IB outlet tells developers like us that, hey, this variable is not an ordinary variable, but is linked to the storyboard or the interface builder somehow. Another thing to notice here is this keyword weak. What you should know about this for now is that this keyword allows us to manage memory for our variables. And weak as opposed to what? Strong? That's right, strong is also a keyword in iOS. Both weak and strong help us manage memory for our variables. The keyword strong means, hey, I initialized that variable, so keep it around till I don't need it anymore. Weak, on the other hand, means someone else created that variable. Someone else. And all I want to do is have a weak reference to that variable. Now, if you want to learn more about these two keywords, weak and strong, we found a great Stack Overflow page that explains these two really well. The link to that page is in the instructor notes. So if I return to my code, I can see that we also have a bang or an exclamation point here at the end. Is this our way of demonstrating excitement for declaring this variable? Not quite. The real answer lies around an idea in Swift called optionals. Swift allows us to declare a variable, like we've done here, and it also allows us to not declare any value for this variable in our code, or have its value be optional. There is a document in the instructor notes that explains optionals and these exclamation points in detail. I encourage you to bookmark it for now and read it later. Okay, now that I have an outlet to this label in our code, I can go back to this function. Remember, this is the action that gets called when we press the microphone button, and change the visibility of our label. So I can say recording in progress, and there is an autocomplete. I can say it is no longer hidden. There. So what I'm saying here is that when this microphone button gets pressed, this record audio function gets called. And at that point, I do not want this label to be hidden anymore. All right, let me run this code and see what happens. All right, so I don't see the label when the app first launches, which is good. And when I press the microphone button, the label starts to show. That's great. So I'm going to go back to my code, slide out my debug area, and then remove this one to do because we've already done it now. Done.